This turbine produces clean energy 24/7 under the ocean, but it's not just any turbine. It's a flying kite programmed to fly in a figure-eight pattern, producing 3 to 10 times more power than a static system. The Swedish company Minesto believes their technology solves the biggest challenges facing tidal power, like producing meaningful power even at slower current speeds. And by doing so, they can reduce cost, increase output, and make this technology work in more areas around the world. So how does it work? What are the pros and cons? And could this be the breakthrough we've been waiting for clean baseload power? Let's figure this out together. I'm Ricky, and this is Tuba Da Vinci. This video is brought to you by Jackery. So what exactly is Minesto doing differently? Think of it like this. Traditional tidal turbines are like trying to generate power with a stationary pinwheel in a gentle breeze. Minesto's technology is more like flying a kite underwater. Their system consists of the following: an integrated nacelle and wing that generates lift from underwater currents, a turbine at the rear powered by ocean currents connected to a gearbox adjusting the turbine rotation to the optimal speed for a generator, and finally, providing control authority is an integrated circuit control system actuating dual rudders and elevators at the rear of the kite. These controls allow the kite to dive, climb, and turn left and right. We'll get back to the genius of this control system in a minute, but having control authority allows the kite to produce 3 to 10 times more power from the same current speeds as a traditional turbine. Also, traditional turbines need currents above 2.5 meters per second to make meaningful power, but Minesto's kites work effectively in current speeds as low as just 1.2 meters per second. That doesn't sound like much, but it potentially doubles the world's exploitable tidal resource overnight, opening up vast areas of the oceans that were previously useless for energy generation. Worldwide demand for energy is skyrocketing, especially in the age of AI. And we can't just burn oil and gas forever because they'll one day run out. Renewables like wind and solar are really promising, and tidal energy is just another form of a renewing resource. But unlike solar and wind, which are heavily impacted by weather and cloud cover, tidal energy is more predictable, driven largely by tidal forces from our moon. The numbers tell the story. Despite billions in investment, global tidal energy capacity sits at just around 500 megawatts. That's smaller than a single large coal power plant. The UK's Maygen project, one of the world's largest, produces only 6 megawatts from its current turbines, enough to power about 4,000 homes. Costs are brutal. Traditional tidal installations run around 3 to 5 million euros per megawatt, with complex underwater maintenance that can shut down operations for weeks. The European Marine Energy Center estimates that only 2% of global tidal resources are currently exploitable with existing technology. Meanwhile, 98% of our oceans flow with gentle but consistent energy we simply can't capture. And this is where Minesto's kite technology comes in. To fully understand this, we have to look at the equation for power generation from a moving fluid. The power in watts is equal to 1/2 rho, the fluid density, times A, the cross-sectional area of the wind from the swept turbine blades, and finally, velocity cubed. So velocity is by far the most important parameter. This means if wind speeds double from 2.5 to 5 meters per second, the power produced goes up by a factor of 8. In a traditional onshore wind turbine, we have an air density value for rho of around 1.2 kilograms per cubic meter. The rho value for ocean water density, well, it depends on factors like temperature, the ocean depths, but roughly speaking, around 1,020 kilograms per meter cubed, 850 times higher than air. So a tidal turbine in the ocean with a current speed of 2.5 meters per second would produce 850 times more energy than a wind turbine in similar wind speeds. But that alone isn't where the genius of Minesto's tech lies. That comes from their flight controls, or swim controls. The wing flies autonomously in a figure-eight pattern controlled by sophisticated software. As it swoops through these patterns, it constantly accelerates through the water, much faster than the current around it. The tether provides both an anchor to keep it fixed on the ocean floor and houses power cables to bring the generated power along the ground and to the surface. The tether acts as a hardpoint, pinning its movement, translating rudder and elevator inputs into that figure-eight pattern instead of just letting the craft drift away aimlessly. Powering our world with renewable sources is the energy holy grail. It's why I love solar and batteries so much, and why, no matter your needs, Our sponsor, Jackery, has a battery for you. From 1 to 5 kilowatt hours of storage, Jackery has it all. And this is my new favorite, the Jackery Explorer 2000. It's the smallest and lightest in its class, weighing just 17.9 kilograms. We just got back from the beach where we pumped up an inflatable paddleboard and cooked some hot dogs on a dual induction cooktop pulling 1600 watts at the same time. Plus, with its dual solar inputs, we were even charging the battery back up. The Explorer 2000 is built to last for years and it's super safe, thanks to its lithium iron phosphate batteries. Keep it charged up and you'll always have 2 kilowatt hours of energy storage in the event of a power outage. It can power your fridge for up to a day, or your laptops and internet modems, or critical medical equipment. Its emergency supercharge mode can recharge your batteries in just 1.7 hours if you're experiencing intermittent outages. And Jackery solar generator bundles come with 2 high-quality portable solar panels, making it a true solar generator. Prime Day is the perfect time to grab one. So get the best deals on a new Jackery battery. Use our exclusive coupon codes for the product you're looking for and my links in the description. Huge thanks to Jackery and you. Now back to the show. The whole system operates completely autonomously, no human intervention needed. The end result of their technology is greater design flexibility. Minesto can create a much smaller diameter turbine, reducing cost, and make similar power, or create significantly more power from the same size turbine. The flagship Dragon 12 system delivers 1.2 megawatts from a 12-meter wingspan, recently upgraded to 1.75 megawatts of generator capacity, while the compact Dragon 4 produces 100 kilowatts from a 4.9 meter wing that fits in a standard shipping container. The system achieves 80% energy conversion efficiency while operating at depths of 50 to 120 meters. Those gentle currents that couldn't spin in a traditional turbine are no problem thanks to Minesto's kites and their figure 8 pattern. This matters because tidal power has the same potential as many of the technologies that we cover, and also suffers from some of the struggles. The economics and levelized cost of energy have to make sense for something like this to, pardon my pun, but take off. Seeing how impactful current velocity is in power generation, this technology is off to a great start. We did a video recently on a pressure geothermal breakthrough that allowed geothermal energy capture in up to 50 to 60% of the world, up from just 2%. And this figure 8 kite turbine has a similar sort of potential. The underwater energy market shows explosive growth projections, with consensus estimates ranging from $4 billion to $8 billion by 2030. Europe leads deployments with 38.9% market share, driven by the UK's 130 megawatt pipeline capacity and France's $65 million commitment to the Flowatt 17.5 megawatt tidal farm. The economics of tidal turbines are rapidly improving through both technological advancements and policy support. Current levelized costs of energy, LCOE, ranges from around 11 to 45 cents per kilowatt hour, with recent project achievements reaching around 12.5 cents, getting closer to the target of 15 cents per kilowatt hour by 2025. Minesto's underwater kites are already powering real communities right now. In the Faroe Islands, both Dragon systems have been operating simultaneously since February 2024, delivering electricity directly to the national grid through utility company SEV, with 2.2 megawatts of total contracted capacity. Now, despite the promising technology, Minesto faces real hurdles before underwater kites can power the world. The biggest challenge is still cost. While current LCOEs range from 11 to 45 cents per kilowatt hour, that's still 2 to 4 times more expensive than onshore wind. Minesto really has to hit those industry targets of around 10 cents per kilowatt hour by 2030 to compete seriously with other renewables. Installation complexity remains daunting. Even though kites are simpler than traditional turbines, you're still deploying sophisticated equipment in harsh marine environments 100 meters underwater. The ocean doesn't forgive mistakes. Supply chain immaturity also creates another bottleneck. Unlike wind and solar, with established global manufacturing networks, ocean energy lacks specialized production capacity. Scaling from demonstration projects to thousands of units means building entirely new supply chains. The permitting maze is equally brutal. Some jurisdictions require 23 permits from 14 different agencies just to get an ocean energy project license. Environmental assessments, fishing industry concerns, shipping lane conflicts, every deployment faces years of regulatory hurdles before the kites ever touch water. But the roadmap does still look promising. Expect first commercial arrays by 2025 to 2027, with Minesto's Faroe Island expansion already planned for 10 megawatts. cost competitiveness with wind and solar should arrive by 2030 to 2035, as learning curves, better supply chains, and economies of scale bring down prices. Now let's talk about putting thousands of underwater kites in our oceans and what it actually means for marine life, because the environmental story here is more complex than clean energy good. The good news first, these systems are actually pretty ocean friendly. Life cycle's greenhouse gas emissions clock in around 15 to 100 grams of CO2 per kilowatt hour, over 10 times cleaner than fossil fuels. And remember, all that comes from the manufacturing side. Once in production, there's zero emission. But here's the surprising part. In some cases, tidal installations can actually improve marine ecosystems. The structures can act as an artificial reef, creating new habitats and increase local fish densities and biomass. These become de facto marine protected areas where fishing is prohibited, leading to larger, more mature fish populations. Underwater noise levels remain well within the acceptable ranges, generally quieter than shipping traffic. And despite years of operations worldwide, there have been zero documented cases of collisions between marine animals and tidal turbines. Although, take that with a grain of salt, I'd imagine that would be nearly impossible to have all the data on something like that. And that's why I'd like to see more studies and reports on just how impactful tidal turbines would be on marine ecosystems. These are massive multi-ton kites, after all, moving through the ocean. And while they do move slowly, they do move. And this will have to be considered and studied, because out of sight doesn't mean that we're not installing these in some marine animal's backyard. I'm also curious about power output and how steady it really is. Since the kite is traversing the waves, it might have an oscillating power output, which is still more predictable than wind and solar, but it might not be a steady state as nuclear or natural gas. But this concern can likely be mitigated in a large installation by shifting the phase of the different kite turbines in a field to blend the different oscillations and create a cleaner, steadier state power output. Right now, island nations and coastal regions face an impossible choice: import expensive fossil fuels or rely on a handful of locations with perfect conditions for renewables. The Faroe Islands were spending a fortune on diesel generators. Remote communities in Alaska, the Caribbean, or the Pacific Islands often pay 3 to 4 times more for electricity than mainland grids. And that's when the power is on and reliable to begin with. Minesto's kites could flip that equation. Suddenly, any coastline with moderate tidal flows becomes a potential energy source. We're talking about unlocking 90 to 98% of ocean areas that were previously useless for energy generation. Imagine coastal Africa, islands along Southeast Asia, or remote Arctic communities gaining access to predictable clean electricity from their own waters. Perhaps most importantly, this technology offers something the solar and wind just can't. Predictability. You can forecast tidal energy generation down to around the minute, decades in advance. Grid operators would know exactly when power would be available, eliminating the costly need for backup systems and grid balancing hardware, which is something that is really important for renewables. We're still early in the race for tidal power, but Minesto's kite turbines are seriously impressive, and I'd love to learn more. So if you want us to go on site, meet the team, get hands-on, and make a deep dive video on this technology, sound off in the comments below. And while you're down there, hit that like button if you like this video, and if you think we've earned it, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss our future videos. Thank you so much for watching, and until next week, check out this video that we did on pressure geothermal, a very similar breakthrough that's unlocking geothermal, another amazing source of energy, at more parts of the world. I'm Ricky with Tuba Da Vinci. Thank you so much for watching.